We have a combination of factors here. We certainly have sea level rise, arguably higher than in other places due to factors like the Gulf Stream slowing down. We also do have more extreme weather events globally, but we have been epicenter for hurricanes, all of Florida. And so we're looking at longer hurricane seasons, more extreme storms. We recently all saw the impacts of Hurricane Ian on the West Coast, and that is a cautionary tale for us here.
Storm surge in particular is one of the most damaging and consequential aspects of a coastal storm or a hurricane. And so it's really part of our overall resiliency strategy and efforts within Miami-Dade County to address coastal storm surge risk for future generations. And it's really important to consider how sea level rise is going to make that coastal storm surge worse and how we can plan and design solutions to address that risk.
This is a complex study. There's so many factors to mitigating coastal storm flooding in the Back Bay.
And we're extremely low-lying here in Miami-Dade County, and we have a lot of infrastructure, critical infrastructure, people, and other parts of our community that are vulnerable. It's quite complex. The diversity of our community and the landscape and just the scale of our vulnerability really is sort of challenging us, right, to get creative with, what is that, those either lines of defense or that systematic approach to be able to address surge, because like you said, a one-size-fits-all or a silver bullet solution, it doesn't exist with the challenges that we're facing and the risks, because, something like a hurricane or sea level rise and a hurricane storm surge on top of that, it affects a range of systems. And so I think to tackle a risk that's systemic, you need solutions that are systemic to help, really, really reduce it overall.
So this project being, I imagine, the largest that is being contemplated is critically important for our economic future as well as our protection.
One alternative is to use natural nature-based features in combination with non-structural, raising homes, doing flood-proofing. That concept is more living with the water, knowing that the areas are going to flood and how can they be resilient after the storm. The second concept, the Atlantic coastline, incorporates previous studies, previous measures, especially the Miami Beach renourishment, which is already a core authorized project, and reinforcing that project and then protecting the greater Back Bay area by coming up with other structural measures, really to protect the whole Back Bay in a multiple line of defense. And it incorporates natural nature-based features by having small islands that prevent fetching whenever a hurricane comes in the Biscayne Bay.
This is a couple of different ideas that have been floated by the county through our work with consulting organizations, and we're looking forward to getting input from our community.
We are committed to working with Miami-Dade and getting feedback from the public, which is critical to the success of this project, to get buy-in from the public. This is part of their solution to mitigating storm risk.
It's been a process. We've had multiple community convenings, draft plans, and we're doing what we call a reset to look at a more nature-based approach. This is very important because we all live here with the water, and we don't want to just create barriers. We want to work on ways that we can divert water more naturally and work with our coastal cities and also our Back Bay and inland cities to have a more equitable approach that will benefit more of our communities.
The core is committed to working on these alternatives with Miami-Dade so that we can get to the go, no-go decision with Secretary Connor in August. And hopefully from there we can move on to the feasibility phase the next step for coming up with solutions for Miami-Dade.
We're so pleased that we've had multiple offices of the Corps involved, and that in this administration with Assistant Secretary Connor, we've been able to say, please, let's start fresh and look at some new alternatives that will be better received, better accepted by our community, as well to incorporate some of the nature-based solutions that are gaining prominence all around the world.